Hello everyone, in this video we have one triangle and these two sides are given as equal, and then these angles are given 40 degrees and alpha is asked. Okay, first of all, I want to represent these two equal sides with x, and I am going to call here y. So this side must be equal x plus y. Right? Okay, so now what can we do? First step, let's call here point K, and I will separate the side into two parts, y and x, like this. Why? Because if we connect A and K point, thus that we get two isosceles triangle. So triangle ACK is an isosceles triangle, right? Therefore, angle KAC and angle AKC must be equal 70 degrees. Okay, we know that here is 100 degrees, right? So 30 degrees left here. Notice that there's a 30 degrees here, right? Therefore, if we mirror triangle ADK over line AK, we get an equilateral triangle, right? So as x and point K, if we take the symmetry of the triangle ADK with respect to this line, so let's draw perpendicular and let's extend here. These two parts must be equal, right? Because of symmetry. And let's call here point T. If we connect K and T points, we get an equilateral triangle, right? Why? Because notice that the base is divided into two equal parts, and here is 90 degrees. After that, let's clear here. If we connect A and T point like this, if here is x, this length is also x unit, right? Because of symmetry. And if here is 30 degrees, that means here must be equal 30 degrees. Notice that triangle ADT has become an equilateral triangle. And then, if you focus on this triangle, triangle BDK is an isosceles triangle, right? So angle DBK and angle DKB must be equal to 20 degrees. Next step, if here is 40 degrees, so here must be equal 40 degrees, right? Because of symmetry. And then if you focus on angle DKT, this angle equal 60 plus 8, right? Why? Because notice that sum of these angles equal 60 plus 8. So angle DKT must be equal 140 degrees. And notice that angle BDK is also 140 degrees, right? Therefore, if you focus on triangle BDK and triangle DKT, these are congruent triangle, right? Because these two triangles have same angles and same side. So triangle BDK and triangle DKT are congruent. That means the length of the BK must be equal to the length of the DT. Therefore, this length and this length are equal, right? We know that this triangle is an equilateral triangle, so here is also x, right? That means here must be equal x unit. As a result, notice that we get an isosceles triangle, right? So triangle BKC is an isosceles triangle. So let's call here theta. That means here is also theta. And we know that two interior angles equals one exterior angles. So here must be equal to theta. And this triangle is an isosceles triangle. So 2 theta equal 20 degrees. That means theta equal 10 degrees. Right? Let's write here 10 degrees. That means alpha equal 30 degrees. Okay. This was the first method. Now we will calculate value of alpha using second method. If you focus on this triangle, I'm drawing the same triangle here, like this. Let's call here point K. Therefore, triangle DAC and triangle BKA are congruent. Okay, and then this side, I'm going to grab this in width A, so here is also A, and let's call here B, so this length is also A plus B. Next step, these two sides are equal A, right? And angle BAK is 40 degrees because of congruent, so 60 degrees left here. And if we connect K and C point, notice that triangle AKC has become an equilateral triangle, right? Therefore, here, this length is also A, right? So we know that here is 60 degrees, and here is 100 degrees because of congruent. If you focus on triangle CKB, this triangle is an isosceles triangle, right? So these are must be equal 10 degrees, and we know that here is 40 degrees because of congruent. So alpha is going to be 30 degrees. Okay, now we will calculate value of alpha using third method. First of all, let's call here x, and here is also x, and let's call here y. So here is x plus y, right? And then here is 100 degrees, right? So this angle is 40 minus alpha. And if you focus on this triangle, we can apply sine rule, right? Okay, according to sine rule, x over sine 40 equal x plus y, this side, over sine 100, right? So x over x plus y equals sine 40 over sine 100. This is the first equation. Now, if you focus on the biggest triangle, For a bigger string, we can also apply sine rule. Therefore, x over sine alpha equal x plus y over sine 80 minus alpha. Right? Therefore, x over x plus y equal sine alpha over sine 80 minus alpha. Okay. This is the second equation. So if we equalize first and second equation, because these are equal, so sine 40 over sine 100 equal sine alpha over sine 80 minus alpha. And then, you know that we can calculate sine 80 instead of sine 100, and the expansion of sine 80 equal 2 times sine 40 times cosine 40. So these are again. And then we know that there's a 1 here, right? So it can be written as sine 30 instead of 1 over 2. And we can calculate sine 50 instead of cosine 40. Right? Now we can see easily alpha equal 30 degrees. Thanks for watching. If you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe my channel. Take care and bye bye.